Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.2 has been out to developers and beta testers for about a week and a half at this point. I've been using it full-time on my main device, my iPhone 13 Pro Max. I've also been using this Apple Wallet to try and give it a try instead of sitting on a regular wallet, but this is what I've been using, so I thought I'd share that. And also, as far as using this, I've got it on my iPad Pro and also my iPhone 6S Plus. Now, the overall experience has been very hit or miss, and it definitely needs some work. However, it's an early beta, so I'm not going to fault it too much. And if you're not familiar with iOS 15.2, it brings a few different things with it. That new app privacy report is here. Under Settings, Privacy, and App Privacy Report. Apple promised this with the introduction of iOS 15, and then they finally brought it to sort of a visual interface where we just had a report before. So this is something we've been waiting for, as well as changes to emergency SOS and other things as well. But there's definitely still some issues with it. So this will bring security updates as well. And this past week, we really thought we'd see iOS 15.1.1 because Apple released a few different things. They released tvOS 15.1.1 and HomePodOS 15.1.1. So we really didn't expect that, but they also did that along with a fix for macOS 12.0.1 for Intel Macs with a firmware update. And they also made available IPSW files for M1 based Macs for macOS Monterey. So all of those things released, but they didn't release an iOS update, which is very unusual at this point. So we do have those released. You can see on Apple's website, this is a public facing website. You don't have to log in to see this. They also released Test Flight 3.2.1, and you can see tvOS and macOS here in beta form as well. It shows you everything that's currently available to the public. Now, along with that, we really thought we'd see iOS, but maybe we're going to see it in a week or so. We'll talk about that in a moment. So I thought we'd talk about the overall experience since it's changed a little bit since the first initial few days using 15.2, and then talk about what they need to fix based off of my experience and your experience on the YouTube community poll, where we have 32,000 votes and 311 comments at this point. Now, the first thing has to do with Wi-Fi and cellular. This seems to be a constant issue for me, at least on the 13 Pro Max. And while when I'm connected, it seems to work fine, you'll see I have two bars of 5G here, as well as Wi-Fi. Now, if I go off of Wi-Fi, sometimes websites won't load, and cellular, even though it's connected, will have to sort of be reset using airplane mode. I'll turn that on, turn it back off, it will reset the connections, and then it will work just fine. Sometimes this happens over and over. So it's something I'm experiencing regularly, probably about 5 times at this point. And so, of course, if you're experiencing those issues, you want to report those in the feedback app, since it's definitely a problem for a lot of people. So that's something I've been experiencing regularly. I've also had random lockups and freezing. So whether I'm in music, maybe going through an album, sometimes it will just lock up. It won't scroll at all. And then I'll have to close the app out and then go back in, and then it will sort of resume and work properly again. I've experienced this with multiple apps, whether that be on music or third-party apps or anything else, I've had that happen. I've also had the iPad completely reboot on me with 15.2. So I've had it just sort of freeze up, reboot, and then start over again. Others have had apps crashing as well. So I'm experiencing that. And also notifications have been acting strange. In fact, here's a little screenshot I took where Notification Center, I cleared it and then it just left this line here. Many times it won't clear my notifications. And when it does clear it, it sometimes doesn't clear the smart notifications or summary throughout the day. So I've been experiencing all sorts of strange things throughout the day with these and the OS in general. However, it's been okay in other areas. Bluetooth has been pretty good, so switching with Bluetooth seems to be great for me. So if you're on AirPods 3, maybe using the new AirPods 3, and maybe using your iPhone, and then you switch to an iPad, the switching is very seamless, almost too good for me, where it actually switches sometimes when I don't want it to. If I just check something, it jumps around and then sort of switches back and forth. So it's something I've been experiencing. So it's working great, not only with this, but macOS as well. So I've been very happy with that. But some people are experiencing Bluetooth with third-party speakers. There's some odd issues. Or on macOS, people have had issues with USB-C hubs and things. So there's definitely some issues that need to be worked out. And that's just the OSs in general when they're released early on. Now, as far as other issues, well, when you connect your AirPods, other people have shared with me Vasile's AirPods Pro here. You'll see once they were connected down at the bottom, they have sort of a title that really shouldn't be there. It says Charge Now Action Title. So this is sort of developer code that's showing up in the overall screenshot here. It doesn't make a lot of sense for it to be showing, and I'm sure it's a bug. So again, all of these things really need to be reported. Another thing people are seeing is misaligned icons here. So when the weather loads, sometimes these icons along the weather here showing what the next day will be like are misaligned. And then there's also messages having UI glitches if you're using character count. So if you're in your messages, sometimes there's odd glitches with that. So a lot of really small, strange bugs right now. Nothing that really causes the phone to not be usable, but there's definitely some odd issues throughout. So it seems to be okay in general with regular use, but those are all of the small bugs. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, if we go out of the privacy report here, go over to my battery. Battery health should be 100% since it's a fairly new phone. I charge it every single night, just leave on optimized charging and let it do its own thing here. And as far as battery life, if we go over to the last 10 days, you'll see yesterday doesn't look like it was too good, but I had a lot of screen off time. So 2 hours and 36 minutes of screen on time, 7 hours and 39 minutes of screen off time. The day before, let's go there, 3 hours and 51 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 24 minutes of screen off time, and I only used 50% of my battery. I'm still finding that by the time I go to bed, I'm only using about 50% of the battery, not even. Usually I'll have about 55% in a long day. So if I wake up and maybe take this off the charger at 8 in the morning and I'll put it back on the charger, usually around 1 in the morning the next day, sometimes like that. Sometimes I have over 50% regularly I do with this phone. However, I do put it on the charger from time to time in my car, just on a wireless charger. So sometimes it makes a difference, but most of the time this has really impressive battery life. I easily get through 2 days if I didn't charge it with regular use, just doing social media and things. Now, the overall battery experience on the iPad is a little bit different. So on the iPad, the experience is pretty good as far as using it, other than what I mentioned where it just sort of crashed all of a sudden and rebooted or had a respring issue. But battery life is where it continues to be a problem. This is a newer iPad. It shouldn't have any issues with that. And you'll see I've been using it, well, 33 minutes yesterday, an hour and 20 minutes today. It was last charged to at 1:13 a.m. last night or this morning. And you'll see I've only used it for an hour and 20 minutes and we're down to 80%. So that I'm still getting 5 to 6 hours of screen on time with this device. It should be getting about 10, and I find that I have to charge it more and more often. I had this issue before, then it was resolved with the release of 15 or iOS 15 and iPadOS 15, and it seems to have come back. So unfortunately, battery life on my iPad is still sort of not great, but it's okay on the iPhone. When it comes to performance overall, I really haven't had any issues other than those occasional lockups. So that's something with the operating system. I haven't had any issues with smoothness. You'll see on the iPhone 6S Plus, as I scroll through, I just booted this up, although the battery is pretty low on it right now. As I scroll through, you'll see it's running okay. It's fairly smooth. I've had no issues. Loading different apps such as Minecraft seem to be okay. So we'll give it just a moment here and see if the frame rate holds up. But generally, it seems to be very smooth with this beta. So performance-wise, you'll see it loaded pretty quickly there. We'll give it just a moment. Now, it did take about 30 to 40 seconds for it to load, but now that we're in, you'll see it's nice and smooth. So the frame rate seems to hold up okay. I don't see any performance drops or anything with this version of the OS overall, even on the oldest of phones. So it seems to be fine. And the phone is not getting too warm. It is warming up a little bit as the processor works harder for a game, but that's completely normal. I haven't experienced anything with heat being a problem on this version of the OS. The phone is not getting overly warm for me. It's not bringing down brightness, although it is getting a little bit cooler outside now, but it's not bringing down brightness when recording video with it or anything like that. So it seems to be much better as far as performance and then just heat overall. Now, as far as iOS 15.1.1, I really expected Apple to release it this past week. In fact, with those releases of TV and HomePod OS, I thought for sure we'd see a final release to the public this week. Now, that doesn't mean they won't push it out to next week. We could have it as soon as Monday. But then again, we just don't know what Apple's doing this time. They could wait for iOS 15.2. So they didn't really say what was in 15.1.1 for HomePod or tvOS, other than small things, security updates. But again, they didn't mention anything specifically. So there's definitely something in here worth updating for. Hopefully they'll push it to iOS, and then we'll get iOS 15.2 beta 2 this week if we don't get anything else. I would expect beta 2 on Tuesday or Wednesday at the latest, generally based off what they do in the past. Typically, we're on a 2-week cycle. If they push it out 3 weeks, that'd be very surprising, since they normally take a break sometime in December. So we'll either have a final release in early December. If we don't see that, you can see these released generally in January. They take the last couple of weeks in December off. So if we see maybe a beta 2 this coming week, maybe a beta 3 the following week, beta 4, and a final in the first week of December, that makes sense. If not, if we're on a 2-week cycle from here on out, we'll see it a little bit later on. So we just don't know until we sort of get an idea of what Apple's doing as far as pushing out updates. But at least we can count on maybe 15.1.1 before the end of the year, if not 15.2. Now, should you install iOS 15.2 betas? Well, I would probably wait at this point, since there's some bugs that are there initially. Generally, with early betas, there'll be some bugs since they're adding features, and then they'll sort of fix things with later betas. So I would wait for beta 2 or beta 3, something along those lines, and then maybe give it a try if you don't mind maybe having some bugs and reporting feedback on those issues on your phone. Otherwise, I would probably hold off until it's released to the public. That or iOS 15.1.1. Either way, if you want to stay with a stable or more stable public release and you're worried about bugs, that's what I would do. Otherwise, go ahead and try out the beta, but just make sure you have a backup first. Now, as far as your overall experience, I've covered this some in a previous follow-up video. And as you can see here, now that we have 32,000 votes, let me refresh here. 32,000 votes. So thank you to everyone that voted. 14% of you are using the beta. 70% of you are on iOS 15.1 or older, which again, there are some issues with that. We'll talk about that in a moment within the comments. And then 5% of you are on iOS 14.8.1 or older. 2% of you are staying with iOS 13.7, and 9% of you are on Android. Based off of week over week or even month over month, it looks like the Android numbers actually come down a little bit based off of some other ones we have. But either way, let's take a look at some of the comments, and we'll just take a look at some of the newer ones since I read some of the older ones before. Fred Mertz says iPhone 8 with 15.1, scroll locks within several apps, mostly Google and Safari. Sometimes simply pressing the home button resets. Most of the time it's necessary to double click the home button and close out apps. Otherwise, battery is fine. No other problems. John says running iOS 15.2 beta 1 on iPhone 13 Pro, the phone is getting very hot and the brightness dims badly. And like I said, I haven't experienced that myself, but again, not everyone's experience is the same. iOS 15.2 beta 1 13 Pro Max having issues with battery draining at night with the AirTags using 100% background. Apple needs to fix that issue with AirTags as they are constantly running in the background and draining the battery. You can turn that off. Unfortunately, when you do, it's going to disable the functionality of AirTags. Also, you could plug in the phone at night, but it still shouldn't be using a whole lot of power doing nothing as well. Samuel says on iPhone 13 Pro Max, so far it's pretty good, unlike the previous update. Battery seems a little bit improved in this update as well. No more freezing apps or bad internet speeds. Thank you for the good work, and thank you. Erwin says iOS 15.2 beta 1 installed on my 10R. Speed improvement is noticeable. Exiting from the camera app is smoother, and unlocking notes with Face ID is also faster. Will says 15.1 battery on the iPhone 12 Pro Max initially was very good, but after 6 days has deteriorated to poor. Or to very poor. Mr. Wesley 911 says performance on iOS 15.1 is great. However, I was experiencing subpar battery on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. For some reason, the home app was draining battery in the background, even though I don't use it whatsoever. I've reset all settings yesterday and already noticed an improvement though. Robert says no problem found so far with 15.2 beta 1 on iPhone 12 Pro. Bbruce 65 says battery life is doing great running iOS 15.2 on an iPhone 13 Pro Max. Having issues where the screen locks up in apps. The only way to solve it is to close out the app and restart. I think it's an app issue and not the phone itself. Wayne says iPhone 7 and iPad Air 2 both running pretty good. No problem so far. I erased and restored the iPad before the iOS 15 update to get rid of a bunch of other data. It's only a 16 gig model. Seems to be a lot peppier now. iOS 15.1 is a massive improvement over 15. Initially, the battery drain on iOS 15.1 was ridiculous. After iOS settled down for about a week, it really improved over iOS 15. Is it me or did this seem to take longer than normal for the background processes after an upgrade to settle down? I've heard this a lot with quite a few people where it just seemed to process longer in the background. After a few days, it seemed to be much better. However, iOS 15.2 resolves a lot of issues, but continues to have a few issues like I mentioned before. So I'm looking forward to beta 2 and maybe an iOS 15.1.1 release to fix maybe security issues and other initial bugs. But let me know what you're looking most forward to with iOS 15.2 in the comments below. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.